to give all honors and praises and glory belongs to my Lord and Savior, whose name is Yahweh, Bahasham, Yahawashi, Bahasham, Wahavakar Kodash. The name of the Heavenly Father is Yahweh, and his Son's name is Yahawashi. And he reverence and honors to the elder apostles of great Norse that taught me this truth, okay, and to the hopeful elect across the globe, and to the few, the very few brothers and sisters listening and also learning the hopes of being saved in these last days. Okay, this lesson is going to be called the Everlasting Kingdom. Heavenly thoughts on the everlasting kingdom. This is where our minds need to be. Alright, this is John 14. Let your heart be troubled. This is Yahawashi speaking. Let your heart be troubled, because in this world, the way this system, Esau has designed this system, is so that you're troubled, it's so that you're anxious, it's so that you're worried, it's so that you're doubtful. Yahawashi says, let not your heart be troubled. Why are you troubled for? Why are you doubting? You believe in the Most High. You believe in the Most High, right? Believe also in me. You believe in the Most High, you're going to believe in Yahawashi. In my Father's house are many mansions. Not some, many. And mansions is what? A place of an abode. A place of dwelling. Dwelling places. And this is why I got this image right here, as you can see. There's many abodes. Okay. You just see, this prophets have to have vision. Prophets are visionaries. There's many abodes, not just earth. Okay. If it were not so, I wouldn't have told you. Okay. Many galaxies. Okay. Earth is just one of them. There's many galaxies out there that have life. Okay. If it were not so, I would not have told you. See, Yahawashi said, this was not the case. Why would I even be telling you this right now? Okay. I go to prepare a place for you. Okay. So it's being prepared right now as we speak. You see how much Yahawashi cares for his elect. That means he's in the heavens and he's still serving. Yahawashi is still serving us. I go to prepare. When you're preparing, you're serving. You're getting something ready. I prepare a place for you. So Yahawashi is doing that with the angels right now. Okay. Designing different architecture, different landscapes. Oh, it's going to be beautiful. This is what we've got to be thinking about. See, this is how you overcome that spirit of death, that spirit of doubt, that spirit of uncertainty, by going into the scriptures and believing. And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again. Okay, what do you invite? You're preparing example, if you're preparing a banquet, what are you preparing? You're preparing it for guests, and you're going to get it ready. And you're going to invite people, okay? And I will receive you unto myself, that where I am, there you may be also. So the elect, they're going to be with Yahawashi. Why? Because they belong to Yahawashi. Come on now. Come on. Let me just a minute. Let's lift up your spirits. Come on. You know, we're not going to be in this situation forever. Now let's go to this way. I want to get this in the right order. Okay, we have an everlasting kingdom. You've got to remember that. Okay. Let's go to Psalms. Hold on a minute. This is Psalms 45 and 13. Right? Thy kingdom is an everlasting kingdom. Whose kingdom? Yahawashi's kingdom. Everlasting. Okay. That means there's no end to it. And thy dominion is endured for all generations. So this dominion, there is going to be no end to it. It's not going to cease. We're not going to ever go into captivity. Okay. After this kingdom is taken down, we're never going to go into captivity again. Okay. The punishment is now. Okay. The punishment is when the nuclear missiles hit. After that, we're not going to be going into captivity again. Right? So now we're going to go to, because all the previous kingdoms, what happened? They fell. Let's go to Daniel's. Okay. Go to Daniel's. You have to have vision. Okay, in this truth. Okay. Go to Daniel's 2 or 4. hold on just a minute. This is Daniel's 2. Where should we start? 31. And our king saw this, and behold, a great image. This is when Daniel was breaking down the interpretation for what Nebuchadnezzar said. Okay. Now our king saw this, and behold, a great image. Okay. And this image, great, this brightness of stood before thee, and the form of the arrow was terrible. Right? This was the statue, okay, that was presented before Daniel in that vision. The image said was of fine gold, which represented by the Babylonian captivity, the Babylonian empire. Okay. And his breast and his arms of silver, which is what later, what the Medo-Persian Empire, okay, the Darius and Xerxes, his belly was of fires and brass, which is what Alexander, okay, the priest, okay, and he just took him down, okay, that was the belly of fires, that was the Greek Empire, his legs of iron, his feet part of iron and part clay, okay, and that represents what? The system that we are in today. His legs of iron, his part iron and part clay. His legs of iron, okay. And remember, you had the Roman Empire, okay. His feet part iron and part clay, okay. Today, the clay would be represent what the Greek nations economically, okay. And the iron would represent what the strong nations economically also. And our service too, that the stone was cut out without hands, okay, which smote the image upon his feet. And you notice as well, the image, what was it? It was a statue. It was an idol, which really is it's a merging of all these kingdoms. Because every one of these kingdoms that were taken down, if you notice something, most of these kingdoms, they would merge the empire that they took down, they would merge their philosophies. And that's why you have something called a pantheon, a melting pot of religions. Okay? They smote the image upon his feet and they were iron clay and break them in pieces. That's what Yahawashi was coming to do. Okay, he's that stone. Remembers the iron and clay and brass and silver, the gold broke into pieces together and became like the chaff, the summer flesh and flaws, which is what residue, and the wind carried them away, and that no place was found for them. Okay? Because America, what? It's an incorporation of all these different what kingdoms. They call it Chaldee, they call it Nineveh, they call it Greece, they call it Rome, they call it Babylon, because it took on what the same customs, okay? And the stone that which the smoke image became a great mountain and filled the whole earth. Okay, the mountain will represent what the governing body of what Israel. So now we're going to go to Daniel 7. Okay, and this is when our kingdom is going to come in Daniel 7 and 27. Okay, before we go to that, let's quickly go to Luke 11 and 18. This kingdom can't stand. Why? Because you've got Edomites that are against Edomites. Okay. A lot of them Ukrainians, they're Edomites as well. Okay, look what's going on with Ukraine, Russia, US. These are Edomites against Edomites. Okay. Let's go to Luke 11. Kingdom can't stand if it's warring against each other. And that's why Esau, what he uses, what separation. Because he knows that he could separate. Okay. He could divide. And that's what Esau does. Let's go with Luke 11 and 18. Alright. And it's this is still a part of the lesson, okay? Because you may be thinking, well, about an everlasting kingdom. Yes, but before we have the everlasting kingdom, these things need to be played out. Luke 11 and 18. It's in Luke 11 and 18. And 15. But some of them said, he casteth out devils through Beelzebub, the chief of devils. This is with the wicked, jealous Pharisees that were hating on Yahawashi, saying he's casting out demons by demons, Beelzebub. Another word for Beelzebub is what a demon. Okay. Which was silly in the first place because a demon can't cast out another demon. Okay. And others tempting him, sought of him, a sign from heaven. Okay. They're being wicked. But he, knowing their thoughts, said unto them, every kingdom, okay. Every kingdom divided against itself, and this kingdom is divided. Even within Esau's kingdom, you have division, as you can clearly see. Okay? It's brought to desolation. So that's how we know this kingdom is going to be brought to desolation, beginning with Babylon, America. And the house divided against a house falling. Okay? And you can also apply that to what? The House of Parliament they couldn't even come to an agreement when it came to the whole Brexit. How long did that take? Okay. I mean, you could also apply that to men. They may start up a camp, but it was not really built upon Yahawashi. It was built upon madness. It was built upon different belief systems, different philosophies. That's why if you have a camp, if all of you believe in something different, eventually it's going to fall. Because a house also represents a camp. It's a dwelling. It's a temple. So a house divided against itself falling. Right? If Satan also is divided against himself, how shall his kingdom stand? Right? So if you're doing the will of Satan, okay, and Satan divided against himself, how is your kingdom going to stand? Okay. Because you say that I cast out devils through Beelzebub. Okay. Okay. And if I be Beelzebub and cast out devils, whom do your sons cast them out? Therefore shall they be your judges. But if I with the finger of the Most High cast out devils, no doubt the kingdom of the Most High is come upon you. And it's coming, it's right here. It's already started. Because remember the scripture says the kingdom of heaven is given us. But there's also going to be a what physical manifestation of that also. Okay. Now let's go to Daniel's Abakashah. This is our expectation. Not this world. This world is of Satan and it's going to fall. Okay, so if you have draped yourself into this kingdom, which this kingdom is of Satan, this is Satan's world. So it's going to fall. Okay, if you made an allegiance with Satan, you're going to fall along with him. If you sold out with Satan, you're going to fall along with him. Okay, let's go to Daniel 7. Daniel 7 and all this pollution, the earth polluted, everything. What's going to happen in our kingdom? Everything's going to be perfect. Yeah. Everything. You're really going to know the meaning of perfection when your Habashah's kingdom comes. Bear me just a minute. Okay, this is Daniel 7 and 27. Okay. 25, and he shall speak great words against the Most High, he this devil, and wear out the saints of the Most High. That's why brothers are feeling a bit worn out, because that's Esau. Okay, putting up his left hand's enchantments and all that rubbish. And to think to change times and laws. This is what he does. Adds a day, takes away a day, and laws, and they shall be given into his hand unto a time. And the times and the line of time, but the judgment shall sit, and they shall take away his dominion to consume and destroy it unto the end. And the kingdom and the dominion and the greatness of the kingdom under the whole heaven shall be given to the people of the saints of the Most High. Who's that? You so-called Negroes, Hispanics, and Indianos, whose kingdom is an everlasting kingdom, and all dominion shall serve and obey him. And that's beginning with what Yahawashi. Hefer 2 is the end of the matter. As for me, Daniel, my cogitations, his mind, much troubled me, okay, when he saw these visions, and my countenance changed in me, but I kept the matter in my heart, right? Because he was expounding it, but I didn't quite understand, rightly understand now. So with this lesson, I hope this was edifying, and yes, I hope you are left. Have a lot to look forward to, okay? Until the next time, Shalom.